Hello everybody, this is Brad92, and today I'll be looking at Uranus Saver from the Solar Saver Space Deliver series. This is the third and final mecha. Since I did the Giant Saver mecha earlier, I figured I should do this one now. I figured to get the other one out of the way because it was first in the Chinese Super Sentai series. So this will be the third and final mecha for the second one. And this is the, this is the mecha. It is like a space battleship Yamato thing with a dragon head on the front, because why not? Very, very big. Like, it's huge. Look how long that is. It's, pretty crazy. Actually, let's just compare. Here's one of the fans' project. Yeah. That's pretty crazy. So, let's get a little bit close in shots here. You can see the dragon head. It has symbols like kind of Gokaiger molded through it. You got some nice metallic blue, clear blue, kind of like a landing pad on the back. You got some like thrusters on the back here. Kind of neat. All in all, it's a very, very cool looking giant ship. That's a nice shot right there. Now, it comes with another piece, which it seems to be for a separate, if I get the camera on the tripod, there we go. It has to do with, like I said, the landing pad here, because you can actually take the Uranus satellite and peg it onto here. And then it comes with, where the heck did I put it? Here it is. It's like a grabby claw, which has a few points of articulation. And it shows you to put it right here, so I guess it's trying to say that you can use it to pick up the satellite once it's docked. You can't really do it with the toy, but it's almost, but not quite. So it's kind of like that. Which, you know, okay. I mean, it didn't get a chance to combine with the, like, securely with the mecha it came with, so here it is. And it's also got some turrets on the front here that can rotate some. So, it's a pretty awesome looking battleship, I have to say. Very nice. And very securely snapped together, holy crap. Alright, let's get the satellite out of here. And we will combine it into its robot mode, because it is a parts former. So you just have to basically rip everything apart. And there's the head, so we can see where he's going. And just have to rip the front half off. And the landing pad, and the legs, which you just have to rotate around and then peg it again the other way. And, oopsie doodles, you get out of here. The legs themselves are just pulled out and they separate. They do lock in place, but not quite as securely as I'd like, because sometimes the force of putting the arms on kind of dislodges it, and then the landing pad just goes onto his bum. You can even add some orange here, and make sure that this part is facing up. And then these are the arms. Now, sad, they only molded in the hands, so they could have like maybe had a part here that separates and folds up, and they'd have arms, but no. Just kind of have like molded in elbow parts and hands. And is present. And make sure these are in the middle. They have to be separate in order to actually go together. And then the cannons can hang up on the top of the shoulders. And then just get those in. They're really tight. They're not going anywhere. Like I said, the legs will collapse before the arms will come off. And that. And then flip the head up. And finally, take the really cool dragon head, and this is like the Red Dragon Thunder Zord from the second season of Power Rangers. Just goes in there. And that's it. That is Uranus Saver in his really awesome robot mode. It is so cool looking. Because it is just one mecha, it's a very uniform color design, and I love it. This is probably my favorite of the three. I like him just like this, in this mode. Not combined. He's very cool. He's got a close-up of that head. It does have the visor. which had the eyes underneath. Really cool head. He has head articulation, which I wasn't expecting. And the arms are ratcheted. And that's it, but still, the head is usually more than you get with a normal Super Sentai. Some clear in the chest here. Yeah, nice colors all the way. And like I said, orange on the back. Lots of orange. So yeah. It reminds me that there's one series from the 80s where the guy would, like, the main character, he'd be blue on the front, and then you rotate him around, he'd be orange. Kind of like that. So comparing him to another mecha, because I still have him here, and he's going to be used for a lot of comparisons. Tokyo. He is quite big, and how about one of the Combiner War figures? Hotspot. So, yep, he is giant. And think about it, he's about half the price of him. He's about the same, he's a little bit more expensive than him before shipping. Just so like $15-$20 more. So, yeah, you're getting a lot for your money. And by himself, he's awesome. Like, if you didn't get him in the other two, he's still awesome alone as a separate mecha, because he looks great in both modes, and he is cohesive, because he's, like, all, uniform color. So he's definitely an awesome-looking robot by himself. But, of course, we have to combine him into, I believe it's called Cosmo Saver. So, he gets dismantled again. See? Yeah, well, the legs do have to go back together, so do that now. And then we take the fanny pack off, rip them in half. Now, these legs, I didn't know what they were going to do initially, and now that I know, I'm really surprised, and it's kind of weird. But basically, you keep them like he was in ship mode, but then you unlatch these side panels. And then you actually fold this, or unfold it. And now you got these clear blue parts. It's like a cape, pretty much. Like a solar panel cape. Which I was not expecting. It's gonna stick out some, as you can see. But yeah, that's different. Was not expecting that, at all. Now the arms. You wanna make sure that these are up. Put these back down. I'm going to flip these in, just for now. Now this is going to be the top of the new arm for the Combiner, just the top half. So, same thing over here. And then, this is going to be part of the chest section. Like that. So, we have one final piece to work on, and that is the torso. So, I'm going to take this part, and flip this. Now we're going to leave this up. Well, we're going to flip back for now. So we can bring this up, the new Combiner head. He has, like, sparkly green eyes. Pretty nice. And then this part comes back up. And then you just replace the dragon head where it was in ship mode. Right into his forehead. So lower the little visor. And right back in. So it's like a, kind of like a shaman sort of thing. That's the way I feel, anyways. So everything's ready to go. Now we have to get the other mecha and get them ready. So, got I believe it was Planet Saver and Solar Saver. They're all ready. They've been stripped down to their parts they need to be. And then, we're gonna start by attaching the back piece. Right into his back. Literally. It pays into three different places, which is good. There we go. Now he's already leaning back, because it's very, very heavy at the top. Alright. Then, we're gonna take the chest piece, and with this part facing down, like, or facing up here, and then we're gonna slide, there's grooves in here, and you can see, you might be able to see, there's little grooves in his, where his arms used to go. So we're gonna slide that over top. Like that. Now think about this. Let me just give you a kind of like a frame of reference. That's the new torso. That's the top of his head, of his chest. Yeah, it's getting big. I'm gonna try my best to put it on screen here, because he's already huge. Now, I'm gonna take the arms of... was it Planet Saver, I think? These are his arms. And instead of unfolding the connection points that were for the combination for just the two of them, we're gonna leave it like that. And we're gonna take the upper arm, and I think it's the other one. Let me just see. Because we're going to unfold a connection for it at the bottom here. Yeah, and then we can connect it together. Right like that. And then we can use that port. Right there. So now we have a new arm. And then, same thing right here. Bring out... I want to make sure I get everything on camera here. I bring out the connection port, peg it in, and then give him another arm. Come on. God. Freaking. Get in your new home. Jeez. It's so hard to do. Stay up. Uh-oh. I'm sensing a flaw in this. Anyways. Okay. We're almost done. Whew. So. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Now. So, it's just going to stay like this in the ship mode. And it's going to peg into where it was when it was the dock, the landing pad. Stop that. Stop it. Keep your arm up there. That's going to be a problem. I don't know if it's actually in all the way... There we go. Okay, maybe it wasn't a problem. It was just me. So now he has a chest. Whew. And then, let's see if I can do this one-handed so you can actually see what's going on. Am I going to have to actually stand up for this? Yes, I am. Okay. Basically, this is going to peg around the head of Solar Saver. Ugh. Okay, I'm gonna have to do this with both hands. He is that hard to do. Wow, he doesn't want to go on. Come on. There! Whew. Holy. Holy cow. Okay. Oh. Wow. That was hard. Hard to do on camera, that is. No, actually, it was hard to do initially, anyways. Okay. That, I believe, is... Holy crap! Cosmo Saver. Look at this thing! That's Cosmo Saver. I hope that's his name. Holy crap. Holy crap. That's huge. That is huge. That is huge. That's just all I can say. It's huge. That's what you said. And I gotta show the combination weapon. So you take the... grab your arm, straighten it all up, and then take the drill part of Planet Saver. It goes in there. And the shuttle of, Solar Saver. Take off the handle though for the combination of just the two. This. See these little tabs that have been sticking out? Well, they just peg into here. And then this will peg into some connection points on here. And now we have the actual completed mecha. Just wow. Can I do a comparison? This light does not like to be hit. Let me, fiddle with things here. Okay. Here is Tokyo again. Look at this. Look at that. Holy cow. And... hotspot. Okay. And I don't have a Gundam here. Give me a second. Alright. Real grade. Exia. That thing is a monster. A monster. Basically, before shipping, $150 worth of mecha. Right there, with that, with those three combined. This thing is a it's a monster. It's insane. And I love it. Now let me get these other guys out of the way, because he takes up a lot. He takes up a lot of real estate, obviously, so you need space. You need backspace because of that cape thing that they added, which I kind of wish they'd done something else with, because it just adds more to the back. It's just where, like, I guess he couldn't figure out what to do with his legs. And so they just, stuck it on his back. So now you got that. It's not nearly as bad as, Ultimate Giant Braver. But yeah, it's crazy. God. Yeah, let's just take a closer look at this thing. From top to bottom. Now, the arms can move, but not that far, about as far as the arm is right now with the weapon on it. Any further, it's gonna have issues. You could try, but I wouldn't. Head doesn't move because it's in that cavity. This thing is insane. It's just insane. And I kind of love it. It's heavy, too. Holy frig. I actually weighed it. It weighs about 3 pounds? 3 or 4 pounds. One or the other. It's heavy. Hopefully my shelf will support the weight, because it is, whew, it's heavy. But yeah, if you think this is at all insane, you would not be wrong. But I also like it. So if you want to pick it up, pick all three of them up to make this an abomination, click the link below to go to Sir Toys, and I'll see you in the next review.